Everyone, let's give a round of applause for Icon Prep Academy. They're going to be performing for us a little later throughout this program, so we are excited to have them with us today. Let's give it up for them one more time, everybody. So we are so glad and happy and excited to see everyone in the audience this afternoon now. My name is Japera Denson, and I will be your mistress of ceremony for Florida Gateway College's annual Black History Month program. So we are so glad that you all have decided to come out and be with us today. You might as well get glad about it, be excited about it, because we have an awesome, awesome lineup in store over the next hour or so. Are you glad to be here this afternoon? Awesome. So this is not only a program, but this is a celebration. This is a celebration. We're going to be celebrating Black history. We're going to celebrate Black legacy. And we're also celebrating bright future. So I want you to be relaxed and enjoy this celebration and engage in this moment, in this time to be celebratory. All right. So I do want to introduce at this time, we have Mr. Micah Williams and Ms. Merlin Leal. They are going to come forward and give us a selection. Micah Williams is an eighth grade student from Lake City Middle School. He is active both in the band and in the chorus at his school. Micah is also very active in his church and youth ministry. And then we have Ms. Merlin Leal, who will be his accompanist today. Merlin is a student here at Florida Gateway College, and she plans to graduate this spring semester, 2022. She is taking piano lessons, and she is an active member of the theater production program here at Florida Gateway. So please, let's give it up for Micah and Merlin as they perform Lift Every Voice.
Straight from the presence of God,
Micah Williams and Merlin Lynn, everybody. Let's give an applause for them one more time, please. So next we want to receive our welcome address. And our welcome address is going to be coming from a very special man here at Florida Gateway College. So please help me warmly welcome our president, Dr. Lawrence Barrett.
Wow. Can everybody hear me?
Yes.
I know I have a big voice. I probably don't need this microphone. What a wonderful day. Thank you for coming so far away to bring us that wonderful introduction to this program. Thank you for everyone to be here. Thank you for that wonderful rendition, Micah and Merlin. My name is Dr. Lawrence Barrett. I'd like to welcome you here on behalf of the faculty and staff at Florida Gateway College. Welcome to the 2022 Florida Gateway College Black History Month program. I want to personally thank Travis George and all of the students who have planned not just this event, but the entire month's worth of programming related to Black History Month. I am so proud that FGC has committed itself to this program, and over the past few years, the entire community has worked together to make sure all students, regardless of race, gender, or interests, are working collaboratively and excitedly with each other. This month's program marks the 50th anniversary of a Black History Month program when in 1972, a group of Lake City Community College students believed it was so important to have this type of event. Our college was integrated many years before our local school districts. Students came to Lake City Community College from surrounding high schools, including Columbia High and also the Black high school, Richardson High. During the times of segregation in Lake City, the college welcomed both Black and white students in programs such as our dual enrollment programs. However, to tell all of you that our campus has always embraced Black students would not be truthful. As part of the 20th anniversary of Lake City Community College, it was detailed how the college did not embrace integration. Let me detail what that story told according to the student newspaper, Timber Chatters. The great-grandson of a freed slave, Rodney Deke Brown, had graduated in 1962 from Richardson High School, the segregated institution in Lake City. He wanted to go to Lake City Community College, which had just started an AA program and transfer courses. But as a Black student, he was not allowed. Instead, he attended Edward Waters College in Jacksonville. While there, he was active in the civil rights protests. Then he transferred back to Lake City, where he encountered many roadblocks to his progress from the college and from the community. In 1964, he integrated Lake City Community College, surrounded by FBI agents. People gave him rides to campus because he was not allowed to ride the bus. Finally, the bus service agreed to take him to the campus. He had to walk 5 miles to the bus stop. He recalled at first students wouldn't talk to him, but eventually he became a well-known campus figure. He graduated and worked at the JCPenney store downtown Lake City. Then he trained to be a correctional officer and he worked in the prison system. He later returned to work on this campus as a security guard. And Brown's story was published on the 20th anniversary of his integration of the school. On this campus during the 1970s, there were also some incidents of racism that rose its head. As president of this college, along with the staff and faculty and students, we can never change what took place, but we can reflect and live our lives daily to make sure that our climate and attitude is of complete openness and that everyone, regardless of race, gender, is treated equally and is welcomed equally without bias. So talk is easy, action is imperative and important. So let's concentrate for a second here today at FGC. We have increased our Black students' enrollment significantly over the past 5 years, and we want to mirror our enrollment of Black students based on the population of our 5-county service area. But what is more important is that our Black student success is increasing also. So it's not just about enrolling students, but it's graduating them, finishing them, and completing them. In addition, with the addition of Mr. George as our multicultural director, we're adding lots of programs for our future and current students. One such effort is taking place today at the Richardson Community Center, where some of our students are tutoring local middle school students. In closing, I can assure you that FGC is proud of our work in the community, proud of this program, and others like it. We see success and progress, but we also know and understand that more needs to be done. Thank you and have a great program.
Thank you, Dr. Barrett, so much for that welcome. We now want to bring forward Mr. Keenan Tucker. Keenan is a student of Florida Gateway College who is pursuing his AA degree with a concentration in cybersecurity. So Keenan is going to lead us in prayer.
Good afternoon. May we all bow our heads as I pray. Lord, I want to thank you for allowing me to be here today. And when I say being here, I don't just mean being alive, although I'm very, very grateful for being that too. I want to thank you for allowing me to attend this college, because 60 years ago, people that looked like me wasn't allowed to do that. People died so I could live out their dreams and I could live out my own as well. I want God to watch over me and my peers, because I know we don't make the right decisions sometimes, but we just need a little guidance. You know, every day it feels like I have a target on my back, and then being the oldest of my family, it's like I'm living as a role model, and God knows that I struggle leading my family as well. I pray that God watches over all of us today and keeps us protected and keeps us away from evil. And amen.
Thank you, Keenan. We are now going to have a very special dance from Judah Praise Dance Group. And I want to introduce these three special young ladies. So it's Miss Janissa Dortley, Nikeria Moore, and Tanija Williams. And these three young ladies are middle school students here in Lake City, Florida. They are active in their church, which they attend Mount Pleasant Missionary Baptist. Do we have any Mount Pleasant family in the audience? All right, Mount Pleasant, we see you. And then we also have this group of young ladies. They are under the direction of Miss Sierra McHenry and also Miss Tiana George. So please let us welcome at this time Judah Praise.
Atmosphere is changing, nothing stays the same. Heaven is waiting for the mention of the name. The spirit is moving, burning like a flame. Healing, broken by the one we proclaim. Raise it up, fill the sky. Chains will fall, mountains move, we lift him high. passages of shame, miracles unfolding at the mention of the name. Darkness is fleeing, mercy raining down.
Judah, praise everybody. We now want to introduce Interim Chief Police, Police Chief Gerald Butler. And in, as he comes up, I do want to just say a few words about Chief Butler. Chief Butler is the Interim Police Chief for the Lake City Police Department here in Lake City, Florida, and he assumed that role in 2021. Chief Butler has served with the Lake City Police Department since 2014 as the Assistant Chief of Police. So let us welcome at this time Interim Chief Police, or Police of Chief, Gerald Butler.
Thank you. Good afternoon. First, I'd like to thank Dr. Barrett, Mr. George, for inviting me here. The Lake City Police Department has a close tie with Florida Gateway College. I'd say at least three quarters of my police officers are graduates of this institution. The quality education they get here, anybody who comes here, when you graduate, you deserve it, and good luck with your future endeavors. Just a few words. During Black History Month, much emphasis is placed by the media on nationally known figures, Frederick Douglass, Rosa Parks, Justice Thurgood Marshall. These are well-known figures in our history. However, I'd like to take this opportunity to also recognize some of our local, lesser-known individuals who've made history in their own way here in Lake City. In 1957, General Lee Doc Taylor and Norman Tucker became the first black police officers on the Lake City Police Department. In 1981, Gwen Williams became the first black public safety communications officer in Lake City. In 1986, Debbie Knighton became the first black female police officer in the Lake City Police Department. And then finally, in 2009, Agatha Gilmore became the first black and first female police chief of the Lake City Police Department. I had the honor of being hired by Chief Gilmore and worked by her side for 8 years. Each of these individuals have made history in their own right. I challenge everyone here, make your own history. The future is yours. Thank you for allowing me to recognize these individuals. Thank you.
Thank you, Chief Butler. I like that. Make your own history. Make your own history. We all have the ability to do that. We don't have to repeat history, but we can make a new one. I'm about to say amen, glory to God. Like, we in church, y'all. I almost forgot for a moment where we were, but he still gets the glory anyhow. All right, so I want to welcome at this time, we're going to have a dance by Icon Prep Academy. They're going to do a dance for us, and that dance is going to be accompanied by some drumming. These kids have come all the way from Tampa, Florida, so we want to celebrate them. They made it here safely, and they are eager. They are excited. So let us make some noise for Icon Prep Academy. Another round of applause for Icon Prep Academy. So next we're gonna have a student speaker, but we're gonna have our student speaker introduced. And I'm gonna call forth Ms. Boone and others, Ms. Boone et al, to come and introduce our student speaker for today.
Good afternoon. My name is Tracy Boone. I am the supervisor for Liberty Jess. In 2020, I had the pleasure of meeting Mr. Maurice Lewis. At the time when Mr. Maurice Lewis came to our program, what I discovered about this young man, that he was lost. He pretty much didn't have any goals. When was asked, he didn't know which way he wanted to go. He said he was basically there to just do what he needed to do and go back home. On this journey that I had with Youth Morris, there's been some laughter, there's been some cries, but overall, I am proud to say what an intelligent, smart young man I found out he is. And we formed a mother and son bond. Some nights I went home thinking, where should I go from here? Because some days was good, some days was bad. But God reminded me that he never gave up on me. He gave me a second chance. So I went back and I told God, I heard him loud and clear. So I gave my all. Every day that I would come to work, I gave him my all. And I'm glad to say that I did, because in the end result, he ended up getting his GED through our program, and which led him coming to this college, which I am so honored. I am so honored. I am so honored. Not only that he came from our program and became very successful, but I'm more honored to say he's not my biological son, but I love him just like he is. And I want to present to you Mr. Maurice Lewis.
Welcome to Florida Gateway's Black History Program. I'm Maurice Lewis, 18, from Gainesville, Florida. My major is General AA, and I plan on attending FAMU for a 4-year architecture degree. Even though I'm doing much better, I didn't exactly have the cleanest background, such as me getting arrested, not attending school, and so forth. But I opened my eyes and realized I need to change. So I obtained my GED while incarcerated, then later enrolled in college. But this goes to show, even though Black people struggle and experience many hardships, it's up to you to open up and change. Just like Frederick Douglass, he faced numerous challenges, such as not being allowed to read. He overcame those roadblocks and bettered himself, which resulted in becoming a famous writer and a major impact in American history. Thank you for having me on your program.
Thank you for being here. We are so proud of you, Mr. Lewis, for all that you have done. Look at all these people supporting you. Boy, if you don't feel loved by now. So awesome. And thank you to Ms. Boone for the introduction and for her staff and team that work with students who go throughout you all's program. Definitely do not quit. Be encouraged, because you all are making a difference. You're making a difference in the lives of our the students and of the youth. So thank you for all that you do. I do want to take this time to welcome back. I think we're going to have another. Can we call Icon Prep back again? Are you all enjoying them? Let's call them back again. Icon Prep Academy is going to come and give us another show. So I want to, right now, at this moment, introduce our speaker. But ICON Prep is going to stay here on the floor because they're going to give us one more right before our speaker comes up. So our speaker for the hour is Dr. Dwayne Rayford. And Dr. Rayford currently serves as the Board of Directors, President, and Superintendent of Schools. He is the founding principal for ICON Preparatory School. He has over 18 years of experience in education, and he has worked in various roles throughout his career, throughout his tenure in education. Some of those roles included regional coordinator, area coordinator. He's also served as a teacher, department chair, assistant principal, content specialist, advisory panel member, and chief executive officer. Dr. Rayford has been successful in turning around schools across the United States, and some of the states in which he has left an impact has been Florida, Pennsylvania, Texas, and also California. Dr. Rayford earned his PhD in educational leadership from the one and only Florida Agricultural and Mechanical University, where my Rattlers at in the audience. Woo! And he completed his doctoral dissertation in supplemental education and its impact on student academic achievement. So Dr. Rayford was selected as an American Education Research Association Clark Scholar. And he has consistently led teachers and students to achieve academic excellence by producing scholars who have ranked among the highest performing students on state assessments in multiple regions of the United States. So again, we will have one more selection and performance from ICON Prep Academy, and then the next voice that you will hear will come from that of none other, Dr. Dwayne Rayford.
Thank you. Okay, good afternoon. Good afternoon. Okay, I want to start out by giving a shout out to all of you. I've heard some amazing things about the transition that has taken place here in Lake City. And I think that shows a lot about the advancements that we've made as a people and that you've made here as a school. So I want to, again, start by giving a shout out to you. And we're going to do something that they do at Florida A&M and something that we do at Icon called Two Claps and a Strike. Now, before we do that, I'm going to have Icon demonstrate for you. And then you're going to all do it together to kind of applaud yourself. Okay, Icon, let me get two claps and a strike. Again, two claps and a strike. Okay, now everybody together, we're going to do a two claps and a strike for all of you. Let me get two claps and a strike. Two claps and a strike. Okay, great. So I want to start today by talking about the importance of learning and understanding Black history. And again, I heard some amazing things. And that's great that we're making that kind of progress as a people. When I think about me growing up in school, for me, Black history started with slavery. And there was much more to me and my people and my history and our background than beginning with the slave trade. And learning about Black history, I believe, is something that significantly impacted my life and allowed for me to significantly impact others' lives. So I didn't really learn a lot about my history until I attended Bethune-Cookman University before going on to attend Hillsborough Community College. So I'm a product of a state college as well. I graduated from Hillsborough Community College with my AA degree in liberal arts before going on to Florida A&M. Florida A&M is where I wanted to go initially from the beginning, but I didn't get accepted. But I think Cookman was significant in instilling in me the excellence about African Americans. I learned during my time there and at Florida A&M when I got there that I'm descendant of kings and queens and doctors and lawyers and astronomers and a host of other people that have made significant impact to the world. And that instilled in me the value of not giving up and continuing to move forward. So although I didn't get accepted into Florida A&M initially, that I was meant to go there, just not at the time that I wanted to be. So I ended up going to a state college. I graduated from Hillsborough Community College, went to Florida A&M, received my bachelor's degree in psychology, my master's degree in community psychology, and my doctorate of leadership, my PhD in educational leadership. And so again, I was meant to go that route and get those things, just not when I wanted to. But having that value of not giving up and continuing to move forward is something that significantly impacted my life. I saw the value that an education had on people's lives. So I witnessed several people, many of my family members, communities, neighbors, who suffered some of the negative consequences involved with the lack of education. I'm the first person in my family to graduate college. On my father's side, for a long time, I was the first person to even graduate high school, first male to even graduate high school, and the only one on my father's side who hasn't been convicted of a felony. And so for me, education is really significant, and being able to learn about your history and where you come from, I think is significant to continue to keep us moving forward. After graduating from Florida A&M, I worked in a variety of roles, but the most impactful for me has been founding Icon Preparatory School. And so I know with my students, sometimes they feel like we're hard on them, but that's because we're trying to instill in that excellence. We want you to move forward. We want you to be great. We want you to obtain everything as possible for you to obtain. And so when I see the band playing and the football team playing and going to basketball games with Icon Prep on their shirts and their clothes, for me, I'm watching history unfold. So it's not just a school. It's actually history in the making. So it's learning that knowledge of where we came from and what we're able to do is what pushed me to start Icon and what pushes me to keep pushing them. Our students come from some of the lowest performing schools in the state of Florida. And we targeted those areas specifically because of the need and the problems that they have associated with education. And I'm not knocking any of those other schools, but when they come to Icon, a lot of times we see a different student. We see a very big difference in our student. Icon ranges from K through eighth grade, and so there's a wide variety of students over there. The oldest is in the eighth grade. However, we have students that are taking high school courses, even though they're only seventh and eighth grade, some have earned enough credits to be juniors in high school. We also have seventh and eighth graders that are dual enrolled, taking college courses. And so if things go as planned for those students, I know one in particular here is our drum major, Tremar, raise your hand. So Tremar is an eighth grader, but within the next month, he would have earned 15 college credits. And for me, those are the types of things that are possible if you believe, if you know that anything is possible, if you know your history, if you know where you come from, that can impact where you're going and what you're able to do moving forward in the future. So I want to close again by shouting out you all for looking amazing sitting here. It was people that didn't give up that allowed us to all be sitting here together, mixed in all different shades and colors and ethnicities, races, religions. People fought for that right. It's important to learn about that, and that allowed us to, again, be here today. So in closing, let me get two claps and a strike for everyone in the building again. Two claps and a strike. Two claps and a strike. All right, thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Rayford, for your speech. Let's give him an applause one more time, please. Can we clap our hands and make some noise for all of our performers and all of our speakers for today? Everyone who took the time to come out, we thank you so very much, our audience members. Do you mind if I just call a few names of persons that have contributed to this program and it being a success? We want to give an extreme thank you to Mayor Stephen Witt, Councilman Eugene Jefferson, Councilman Jay Keel, County Commissioner Ron Williams, Interim Police Chief Mr. Gerald Butler. We also want to give a thank you to all of the local pastors that are represented in the audience or in the congregation this afternoon. We also want to thank Ms. Nikita Cherry. I believe she is here as well. And the students of Knee Black Elementary School. And all of the staff and faculty that are on board with Knee Black. We certainly want to thank our Florida Gateway College administrators, our president, Dr. Lawrence Barrett. Our vice president, we have Dr. Gavin in the audience as well. And we have Dean Matt Peace, Dr. Matt Peace in the audience as well. And we want to thank all of our administrators, VP Tony. Thank you so much for your support as well. So all of our leaders within Florida Gateway College, all of our faculty and staff and students of Florida Gateway College, thank you so very much. We also want to thank Mr. Travis George for spearheading in collaboration with Miss Amy Deakle, who is here as well. And all of the students of student activities and the support staff with student activities, thank you all for making this a successful event. We also want to thank our community partners. I hope y'all don't get tired because I'm going down my list. Okay. We also want to thank our community partners and our stakeholders who continue to support Florida Gateway College. And that ranges. Community partners range all throughout North Central Florida and throughout Florida. So thank you for your continued support as well. And again, every single one of our audience members, some had to leave, but thank everyone. We thank everyone who has come out, the dancers, the singers, the accompanists, the ones that prayed, everybody who served on the program. Last but not least, I want to say thank you to Icon Prep Academy for coming as well. And I have just a few announcements before we go, just a few announcements. So one, we have lunch available for everybody out in Pine Square. So please, as you exit the gymnasium, just veer off to the left. Veer off to the left, and lunch will be available for you. We also ask that you please stop by the various tables that are represented here in the gym. Our student clubs here at Florida Gateway College took the time to prepare these tables. And because it's Black History Month, they're representing all of the HBCUs, okay? So please stop by the tables. And then last but not least, for the health science students that are in the audience, please remember that there is a health career fair going on in the MedTech building, building 103, that's still going on. So all of our health science students, please go over that way and see the various vendors and jobs that are represented there. That's everything I have. Anybody have anything else? All right, so here is the request. Before we go, we're going to have ICON Prep to lead us out. They're going to do a recession. So ICON Prep is going to come back. Now, ICON, as y'all get ready to leave, please exit through the doors over here to the left. So ICON and Knee Black, please exit through the doors over here to the left. Miss Casey Schrader is raising her hand. She's going to lead Knee Black and ICON Prep out over here. Everyone else in the audience, you can exit on that side. Your left, my right. All right. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you so much for your participation.
Like to consider FGC as my first grand campus. I never thought I was going to go back to school or have the time to go back to school. Now my son, 12 years old, is looking at daddy after so many years, grabbing his books and going to school, and he's so proud. And I'm teaching him that you continue, my son, and you do what you have to, but be a man of your word and finish what you start.
Start your journey today at Florida Gateway College.